How to start a blog with Hostgator, Hostgator WordPress blog tutorial. Hey guys, Brian with WP Cupid Blog, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to start a blog with Hostgator step by step. I'll also be providing you with our exclusive 60% off Hostgator hosting promo code that will get you up to 60% off Hostgator hosting, plus a free domain name for annual plans or $4.99 for non-annual plans. Make sure you subscribe to our channel as we're always posting new hosting tutorial videos. There are four steps to starting your blog with Hostgator. Step one is signing up for an account with Hostgator. Step two is choosing a hosting package. Step three is registering a domain name. And then step four is installing and setting up your blog with WordPress so you can start creating and making a blog with Hostgator. Let's get started. The first thing you want to do to start your blog with Hostgator is click the link in the description below to be taken to Hostgator so you can take advantage of our exclusive Hostgator discount where you'll get up to 60% off hosting and a discount on your domain name. The Hostgator promo code you want to enter at checkout is Cupid60. A little disclosure, the link is an affiliate link, meaning I'll receive a commission from Hostgator at no extra cost to you. Plus, you'll get an awesome Hostgator discount. Once you click the link in the description below, you'll be at the Hostgator homepage. Click the Get Started button. You'll now see three different web hosting plans, the Hatchling, Baby, and Business plan. The Hatchling plan is a great plan if you're going to have one site. If you're going to have more than one site, then you would want to select the Baby plan, as this plan offers unlimited sites. The Business plan comes with unlimited sites and includes a free dedicated IP, Hostgator's SEO Tool Star add-on, and a free upgrade to a positive SSL certificate. I recommend going with the Hatchling or Baby plan when starting out, and then you can always upgrade to the Business plan as your site traffic and revenue grows. You can upgrade or downgrade to any of the plans at any time. Next, click the Buy Now button on the plan you want to select. You will now see Choose a Domain section. This is where you can search for a domain name for your site or enter a domain name if you already own one. You'll see the search field where you can type in a domain name that you want. Over to the right, you can select a domain extension, for example, .com, .net, .org, and so on. .com is the most popular domain extension, so I'd recommend going with a .com if you can. This is completely up to you. Type in the search field a domain name that you want and just click off to the side or anywhere off on the search field and it'll let you know if it's available or not. If it's unavailable, it'll say sorry this domain is unavailable underneath. If your domain is available, it'll have it selected. If you already have a domain name, just click on the I already own this domain and put in your domain name. If you did choose your domain name, you will see the domain privacy protection. You can select or unselect domain privacy, completely up to you. I do recommend domain privacy as it'll keep your personal information private so that spammers and telemarketers won't be flooding your email or phone with offers related to your business. If you select domain privacy, it'll show Hostgator's default contact information specifically for this. Highly recommend this. Once you do that, scroll down to the Choose a Hosting Plan section. Now, let's add in the Hostgator promo code for the discount if you haven't already. If you click under the billing cycle, you can choose the length of time you want to purchase hosting for. If you haven't already input the Hostgator coupon code, you will see the pricing listed as here. Once you scroll down to the Enter a Coupon Code section and replace the promo code that is there with Cupid60, and scroll back up to the billing cycle, you will now see the new discount being shown to save you money. You can choose to pay monthly, every 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, 24 months, or 36 months. You'll see you will save the most money the farther out you purchase your Hostgator hosting for. Next, you want to enter your username. Pick anything you would like. Now, just enter a 4-digit PIN that you'd like to use. Make sure to remember this, as this is one of the ways that Hostgator verifies your account if you need to talk to their customer support team. Next, you want to enter your billing information. Over on the right hand side, you will see where you can put in your card information or you can pay via a PayPal account. After you do that, scroll down to the Add Additional Services section where you can add any Hostgator add-ons that you would like. All these add-ons are completely optional. You'll see the SSL certificate add-on. Hostgator does come with a free SSL certificate for your site, so this add-on isn't necessary unless you want to upgrade to a positive SSL certificate, which will allow you to show a site security badge on your site if you like, and with the positive SSL certificate, you'll have a $10,000 limited guarantee warranty by Komodo. Next, you will see Site Log Monitoring as the next add-on. This add-on checks your website daily and will notify you immediately if your site has been hacked into and malicious code has been placed into it. Office 365 is the next add-on, and this provides an email address through Outlook from Office 365. Your Hostgator account already comes with email addresses that you can create for free, so I really don't recommend this. Completely up to you though. The next add-on is Site Backup. This will back up your site daily, and you can restore your site to a previous backup with a click of a button with their one-click restore. This add-on can be a good one because if your site gets hacked into or you mess something up while creating it or editing it, you can restore it to the version right before whatever happened took place, and everything will be back to normal. I do recommend this option as you never know when you might need it. The next add-on is Hostgator SEO Tools. Hostgator SEO Tools will provide you with reports, insights, and analytics regarding the SEO for your site, and it'll recommend things to do to improve the SEO of your site. It will also report your site to search engines. This add-on isn't really necessary. Next, you'll be at the Enter a Coupon Code section. If you haven't already, replace the promo code that is there with Cupid60 to take advantage of our exclusive Hostgator discount. Now just scroll down and accept the terms and conditions and click the Checkout Now button. You'll now be directed to a thank you page. Hostgator will now email you your Hostgator receipt and your Hostgator billing and cPanel login credentials so you can begin creating your site. Once you get the email, just click the link to be taken to the Hostgator cPanel login page and enter your credentials to be logged into the Hostgator cPanel. This is what the Hostgator cPanel looks like once logged in. We now want to install WordPress. You will see at the top of the cPanel the popular link section. Find WordPress installer and click this. Next, we want to select a domain for the WordPress installation. Click on select your domain and choose a domain name that you will be using for your blog. Leave the directory field blank, hit the next button. Now you'll be at the install settings page. Fill out what you want the blog title to be. An example of this is the name of your site. Next, enter the admin username, password, first and last name, and the admin email address. You'll see the automatically create a new database being checked. Keep this selected and select that you agree to the terms and conditions. Once you do that, click the Install Now button. You'll now be redirected to an installation complete page that lists out your WordPress login credentials. Hostgator will now send you an email with a login link to WordPress. The easiest and quickest way to log into the WordPress dashboard to create or make edits to your blog with Hostgator is just enter your domain name at the top of the search engine and put a /wp-admin, just like you see here. This will take you to the WordPress login page for your site. I recommend you bookmark this login page so you can easily access it in the future. Once you log in, you'll be in the WordPress dashboard where you can begin in creating your site. Let's get to know WordPress a bit. In the top left of the WordPress dashboard, you'll see the house icon with your site name title. Hover over this and click Visit Site to view your blog. Your blog will be using the WordPress default theme, so you'll notice it'll look pretty basic at first. Now, you just need to customize the site and make it look however you would like. Here's how to pick out a theme for your blog. On the far left, you will see tabs. Find the Appearance tab, as this is where you can change the look of your theme or change your theme to another one or a premium theme. Select Themes. When you hover over Appearance, it will showcase free WordPress themes that you can choose from. If you select Most Popular, it will show you the most popular free WordPress themes. Hover over a theme and click Activate to make the theme your WordPress theme. You should also see Add New Theme on this page. This is where you can add a new theme if you got it from another site or it is a premium theme. A great place to get premium WordPress themes is ThemeForest. I include the link in the description below so you can check them out. You can get already professional made WordPress themes if you don't want to bother with designing your blog, etc. From the ThemeForest homepage, click on WordPress in the menu area. You can now search for specific themes in a particular niche. If you scroll down, it'll showcase some popular themes. Next to a theme, you can click Preview to preview what the theme will look like live on the web. Let's continue in getting to know WordPress. On the far left, you will see Post. Post is where you can add new posts. Pages is where you can add new pages. The Media tab is where you can upload images to your blog or where your images will show that you have already uploaded to your blog. Comments is where you can view comments people leave on your blog. The Plugins tab in the left menu, click Add New. This is where you can add new plugins for your site. Pretty much any feature or customization you would want, more than likely there is a plugin to do that. A great site if you need help with designing your customizations in WordPress is Fiverr. Fiverr is a great place to get tasks done for as low as $5. It is helpful if you need a logo, website changes, or something else done. I provide the link in the description below. That is my Hostgator WordPress blog tutorial on how to start a blog with Hostgator. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more hosting tutorial videos. Leave us a comment, we love hearing from you.